The Pantanal, the world's largest wetland, and not a drop of water in sight. Fires have been blazing here since July, leaving a trail of destruction. So far, there have been more than 15,000 fires, triple the number than the same period last year. It's the worst record since 1998, when the government National Institute for Spatial Research started measuring them.
It's a really sad combination of drought with bad policy from our government, lack of control, and wrong discourse on the media all the time, kind of incentivizing illegal practices towards the environment because they think it's good for agriculture or mining and activities like that, which is a huge mistake. With all the fire that we're getting in the Pantanal and also in the Amazon, it does have an effect on water cycles that irrigates our agriculture in Cerrado and southwards.
Flames have already incinerated animal sanctuaries and also farms like this one.
Within minutes, we saw it all come to an end, including the animals. It's very sad because we couldn't do anything.
And then there is the blinding smoke, which experts say will soon darken the skies in cities like São Paulo, more than 1,000 kilometers away from the Pantanal.
President Jair Bolsonaro has been downplaying the fires, saying they're being exaggerated by environmentalists, the press, and foreign governments. But the smoke almost cut short his visit to the Pantanal. Bolsonaro's plane was forced to abort a first attempt to land in Mato Grosso state, in the heart of the region.
Bolsonaro didn't go near the fires. He visited farmers, rode a tractor, and dismissed criticisms from abroad, like those made by the European Union.
We're being largely criticized and attacked by countries who compete with us, exporting agricultural goods. They don't have problems with fires because they've already burnt all their forests.
But investors, both in Brazil and abroad, have done more than criticize Bolsonaro's policy. They're threatening to stop buying products from a country that doesn't take the environment seriously. Monica Yanakiew, Al Jazeera, Rio de Janeiro.